Hello friends, welcome to Engineering Today, and we're back with our weekly bulletin. We'll take a look at 10 updates today. Number 1. SpaceX Starlink launch marks record Falcon fairing reuse. On the 26th of May 2021, SpaceX completed their 28th operational Starlink launch successfully. The mission also marked a new record of Falcon fairing reuse, along with the 85th successful landing of a Falcon booster. According to SpaceX, this is the 14th Starlink launch of 2021. The mission flew a flight-proven Falcon payload fairing for the fifth time, achieving a significant milestone. At 2:59 p.m. Eastern Daylight Time, SpaceX launched their Starlink 28 mission from Cape Canaveral Space Force Station. The fairings used in Starlink 28 are both flight-proven. One of them has previously supported 4 Starlink missions, and the other fairing has supported a Starlink mission and Transporter 1. SpaceX representatives have stated that each pair of Falcon fairings comprises nearly 10% of the cost of Falcon 9 production. According to a report, fairing reuse has already saved nearly $90 million of the costs. Till now, SpaceX has flown nearly 34 flight-proven fairing halves on 19 separate missions. Let's take a look at the next update, number 2. Tianjiao 2 docks with China's space station module. On the 29th of May 2021 at 8:59 a.m. Eastern Time, China has launched Tianjiao 2 aboard a Long March 7 medium-lift rocket from the Wenchang spaceport in the coastal region. 8 hours later, Tianzhou 2 cargo spacecraft docked with the Tianhe space station module of China in Low Earth Orbit (LEO). By 5:01 p.m. Eastern Time, Tianjiao spacecraft had completed all automated rendezvous and docking procedures with Tianhe. Tianzhou 2 weighs about 13 metric tons. Being a cargo spacecraft, Tianzhou 2 will now conduct a self-regulated propellant transfer of 1.95 tons to the Tianhe model. Tianzhou 2 also contains 4.69 tons of cargo in a pressurized chamber. Tianzhou 2 will remain docked to the Tianhe module for providing food and other necessary supplies for a time span of 3 months to the crewed Shenzhou 12 mission upcoming in the month of June. The Shenzhou 12 mission is expected to launch by the 10th of June. Number 3. Our next update is based on OneWeb constellation. On the 28th of May at 1:38 p.m. Eastern Time, Arianespace launched 36 satellites aboard a Soyuz 2.1B rocket from the Vostochny Cosmodrome launch site in Russia. Adding these 36 satellites to the OneWeb constellation has increased their fleet to 218 satellites. With the commencement of this launch, OneWeb's broadband constellation has crossed the mark of launching more than 200 satellites in orbit. At first, the mission was selected to launch on the 27th of May. Later, Arianespace had delayed their launch to the 28th to replace one item of electrical equipment on the Soyuz launcher at the launch site to make the launch more reliable. According to a report, these satellites were launched and deployed without any issue. Primary orbit had an altitude of 450 kilometers. The satellites will gradually reach their operational orbit, which is 1,200 kilometers above Earth's surface. Let's take a look at update number 4, $2.2 billion funding increase for U.S. Space Force. In the $715 billion defense budget proposal for 2022, President Biden had sought $17.4 billion funding for U.S. Space Force. The present funding is almost $2.2 billion ahead of the funding in 2021. On the 28th of May 2021, the Pentagon announced the details of the president's funding request for the upcoming fiscal year. According to the Pentagon, the $2.2 billion additional funding is brought up for new developments in space systems for the Space Force. They also stated that much of this funding is shifted from the Navy, Army, and Air Force. The Pentagon stated in budget documents that the president's budget funds capabilities for the contested domain of space. Competitors like China and Russia are challenging Americans' advantage in space by aggressively developing offensive weapons to deny or destroy U.S. space capabilities in conflict. In our next update, number 5, NASA requests for $24.8 billion for space exploration and projects. In a budget request dated the 28th of May, NASA has asked for $24.8 billion for the fiscal year 2022 to boost up several existing science and exploration programs and also start new projects. NASA has also proposed to cancel SOFIA, an airborne astronomical observatory. NASA Administrator Bill Nelson said that the president's budget request is recognition that NASA's missions contribute to the administrator's larger goals for America. The present budget request of $24.801 billion is a bit higher than the previous initial request made in April. The present budget request is $1.5 billion more than the $23.272 billion which NASA requested in fiscal year 2021. Let's move on to our next update, number 6, satellite operators on C-band clearing. There are continuous legal disputes and pricey domination relating to C-band. Now, companies are moving forward to clear the spectrum for U.S. terrestrial 5G wireless operators. Specifically, two prominent satellite operators, Intelsat and SES, who gained most of these frequencies, are on their way to clear out part of the band by June and then by December. Tom McNamara, Vice President of C-band Transition at Intelsat, said, "It's similar to moving cars around the parking lot so that they're together and contiguous. So there's a big empty space you can cut off and use for another purpose. Satellite operators are now moving their fleets to clear the 120 MHz band. In the beginning of June, the first step will be completed. It may include some upgrades in consumer terminals and shifting to the new service. The next step is to install filters in every Earth station all across the U.S. to avoid interference." McNamara further said, "All the satellite operators have to move at the same time and all have to get out and wait until the last guy is out to use the space." Number 7. Our next update is based on the Hubble Space Telescope. Recently, the Hubble Space Telescope has captured a photo of a distant spiral galaxy named NGC 2276. This galaxy is situated nearly 120 million light-years away from our Sun in the constellation Cepheus. Hubble also captured a photo of another, smaller galaxy named NGC 2300. According to scientists, the gravitational pull of NGC 2300 has deformed the spiral structure of NGC 2276. Under gravitational attraction from NGC 2300, the outermost parts of the spiral arms of NGC 2276 have stretched away from the center. Moreover, NGC 2276 is also affected by excessive hot gas that strongly affects galaxy clusters. Number 8. Mercury and Venus have recently reached the closest point. On the 28th of May, 2021, Friday, Venus and Mercury reached their closest passing point. This event was visible during the night. According to scientific observations, this similar event will take place no earlier than the 5th of November, 2033. A report says that the pair of planets was dimly visible in the western sky for nearly half an hour to 40 minutes after sunset. The planets will remain relatively close in the sky for a few days. Later, Venus will continue to move away from the Sun. On the other hand, Mercury will sink into the horizon. By mid-2021, Mercury will reappear in the sky as a morning star. All through 2021, Venus will remain an evening star. Let's take a look at our number 9 update. Curiosity captures images of colorful clouds on Mars. NASA's Curiosity rover has recently captured 21 images of colorful clouds in the Martian sky. The cloud in Curiosity's new photos seems much higher in the atmosphere. NASA didn't specify the altitude of the clouds. NASA also stated that the difference in color and heights of clouds is due to different composition, specifically of frozen carbon dioxide. Mark Lemon, an atmospheric scientist with the Space Science Institute in Colorado, said, "I always marvel at the colors that show up, reds and greens and blues and purples. It's really cool to see something shining with lots of color on Mars. On moving to our last update, number 10, Aspergiusniger will be sent for a ride around the Moon. Microbiologists of the U.S. Naval Research Laboratory are preparing some experimental samples of fungi to send for a ride around the Moon by late 2021 or early 2022. As said, fungi have some natural mechanisms to protect from and repair DNA damage caused by radiation. Therefore, they can survive much larger radiation than humans. Thus, they're being part of this experiment. Zhang Wang, NRL microbiologist and the principal investigator on this project, said, "During this past year, we successfully completed the scientific verification test to ensure the experiment is working in our lab, which is the first step of this project. Additionally, since October 2020, we have accomplished an experimental verification test at Kennedy Space Center, which mimics the flight environment for about 2 months. Aspergiusniger, a black mold, will be used for this experiment. Presence of these fungi is detected in the International Space Station. The goal of the mission is to study melanin in fungi as well as DNA repair procedures." Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your valuable feedback in the comment section. This will help us to improve.